this is Gareth from the Edance Learning Lab. How can you write an effective acknowledgement section for your next paper? This is important, and it's a bit of academic paper writing that people often overlook. You need to make sure that you put all of the people who helped with your study, organizations that funded you, equipment or facilities that you used in your study into the acknowledgements, as well as putting in there potentially, depending on your journal, any conflicts of interest. Now, reviewers as well need to be thanked if they've given their names, or even if they haven't given their names. Lots of people write things like, "We'd like to thank reviewer 2 for his or her helpful comments on our paper." So, a good structure for those 2 or 3 sentences that you put at the end in your acknowledgements is to initially thank the people who helped you, who read the paper, who commented on early drafts, or who helped with access to facilities or equipment. So first of all, thank people, then thank access to facilities, any equipment, any big computer facilities, or any other, you know, visits that you made to access content or other facilities. Put those second in your acknowledgement section, and then you'll also need to acknowledge your funding sources. So this work was supported by a grant from X or funding from Y. So that's an effective structure for a good acknowledgement section, making sure that you don't leave anyone out who might read your paper and get a little bit upset or affronted that they did work, reviewed the paper or read the paper or helped with the data analyses and then didn't get their names in the acknowledgement. So be careful, be thorough, and do the best that you can as thoroughly as you can in your acknowledgements. My name's Gareth. Thanks a lot for listening. This is a video from the Edance Learning Lab.